Process improvement is a series of actions taken to make a process more efficient, less costly, safer, etc. The healthcare reimbursement model is shifting to a pay-for-performance type system or a value-based purchasing model. And in preparation for reimbursing providers and facilities based on quality of care that they're providing, the government's requiring providers to adopt certified electronic health records and use them in a meaningful way. What this means is that providers will be expected to not just compile data or information on the patients they care for, but to actually act on that data. And it's here that quality improvement comes into play. There are many methods of quality improvement being used today. Some of the most commonly used ones are total quality management, or TQM, continuous quality improvement, or CQI, Lean, Six Sigma, and PDSA, also known as PDCA. The one that seems to be the fastest and easiest to teach as well as utilize is the trial and learn approach to quality improvement that combines three fundamental questions with the plan, do, study, act process. There are three fundamental questions that get asked with the PDSA model. Number one is, what is it that's trying to be accomplished? Two is, how can one know a change is actually an improvement? And the last one is, what changes can be made that will actually result in an improvement? There are multiple ways to teach process improvement. I generally gravitate towards workshops that are fun and that involve games. There are games that involve assembling paper airplanes and flying them. There are games that involve assembling paper footballs and using them to shoot goals. And there are also games that involve assembling potato heads, and that's the one I choose to use. The P segment of PDSA. This answers the question of what is trying to be accomplished, provides guidance for the team's specific improvement efforts, and it ensures that the team's activities align with the strategic goals of the practice. It needs to be clearly stated and numerical, as well as represent a challenge for the practice or provider. An example of an effective aim statement might be, by June 1st, 2013, our practice will be able to identify 100% of our patients with hypertension using the electronic health record. One needs to ask questions and make predictions. The do segment is where the actual plan gets carried out. Unexpected observations and problems are documented, as well as preliminary analysis of the data that was collected during the do. The study process is where a complete data analysis gets performed. The data collected should be compared to the predictions, and a summary of what was learned should be generated. The act portion is where it gets decided what changes should be made the next cycle based on what was discovered in the last cycle, and the process starts all over again. In a nutshell, the PDSA cycle should be used to predict the effectiveness of change and plan the next steps, revise and adapt changes to the patient's and practice's needs, assess costs and the side effects of the change, as well as to anticipate potential implementation barriers. It's important to implement changes on a small scale until one is certain that they will result in an improvement. It's also important to repeat the PDSA cycle until the desired change matches the aim statement, which means that what was set out to be achieved has been accomplished. Strategies that will help ensure that the change was actually for the better are to use a small set of patients, do it on a small scale, to be as specific as possible, to do it over a short period of time, like a few days to a week, before evaluating the results of the change. While all improvements are the result of change, all changes are not necessarily improvements. By testing and measuring during the PDSA cycle, one can predict the effectiveness of the change and plan the next cycle. It's important to collect just enough data and not to make this part overly complicated. It works best to incorporate the testing into the daily routine. It's helpful to ask the following things when evaluating the test results. Were the changes executed well? Were the support processes adequate? Was the original hypothesis or hunch correct? Despite executing the change well, did it not result in an improvement? And did the local improvement impact access or efficiency? You want to avoid doing the following: the tendency to make the objective statements too broad, confusion between the objective and the questions, the tendency to not anticipate in the plan step how to analyze the data that gets collected, the tendency to do too much in one PDSA cycle instead of multiple cycles, and lastly, the tendency to use PDSA for collecting data on a measure rather than to test on an idea for change.